It's a Halloween travel tradition in downtown Sioux Falls. The annual haunted bus tours are now underway, hosted by Siouxland Heritage Museums.
And unfortunately, all the tours are booked for this year, so we decided to visit one of the popular paranormal stops along the tour. We sent our own Perry Groton on a ghost hunting expedition through the old courthouse museum in tonight's Eye on Kettleland.
The closer we get to Halloween, the more visitors stop by the front desk of the old courthouse museum with one question on their minds.
They want to know if the place is haunted. They're just really curious about what ghosts might be hanging around here.
Museum interpreter Melissa Godburn has an answer at the ready for these ghostly inquiries.
Just say, well, it's possible that they're here, but I've certainly never seen anything. Yeah, and there's always stories. Everybody always has a story.
Stories like the presence of an eccentric caretaker who once lived in the courthouse before it became a museum.
Some people think that he may have imprinted his spirit on the building here. He lived up on the third floor and took care of the building, and a lot of the hauntings supposedly center around the third floor.
Museum educator Pavel Rasmussen has an office on the third floor, where he had his own spooky experience he can't explain.
It sounded like somebody ran their hand across a typewriter that was right behind me at the time. And so obviously there was nobody standing behind me, and then behind that is just the wall that goes to our elevator shaft.
Then there are stories of ghosts apparently try to communicate from the other side through a telephone line.
In our old phone system, the phones would, you know, turn on, and you know, like you'd hear the speaker go on with nobody sitting at the desk. We had pens get knocked over or start to leak and things like that in somebody's desk.
Some people trace the old courthouse museum's haunted reputation back to the days of Dakota Territory, when they used to hold public hangings at this spot in downtown Sioux Falls, right next to where the courthouse would be built back in 1890.
Actually, three men were hanged at this corner where the old courthouse museum was then built, and one of whom we're pretty sure was an innocent man. They actually had to try to hang three times before they successfully accomplished their goal there. The rope broke once, and somebody else walked under the trap door on the second attempt.
Siouxland Heritage Museums has opened its doors to psychics and ghost hunters in the past to try and make contact with these supposed spirits.
I haven't heard that there were any major revelations during the ghost hunting trips. I wasn't personally involved in those.
Rasmussen says it doesn't hurt for the museum to have a reputation as one of the most haunted places in South Dakota. Some visitors who come here for the history are also intrigued by the ghost stories. There's no proof of ghosts inhabiting the museum, but this 130-year-old facility has some built-in features, from its majestic presence in downtown Sioux Falls to age-related creaks and no shortage of darkened corners that can leave even skeptics like Rasmussen to wonder.
It's kind of dark and big windows, so there's always that, you know, you're walking out at night, sometimes you look up, it's like, well, is there something up there where who knows what's going on?
With Eye on Kettleland, I'm Perry Groton.
The Pettigrew Homan Museum, which is also part of the Siouxland Heritage Museums, is another stop along the haunted tour, and people have reported smelling the scent of